esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. It's a very fine Sunday morning for some CS, but you guys may be wondering, you guys may be questioning, why is Semler the one talking us in this morning? Why is he welcoming us to the stream? And that's because Anders got a little sick last night and will be taking a short break at the beginning of the day here. So we'll see how things go. We'll see how he feels. But for the first best of three, it's going to be me and Vendetta. So, Ven, are you here, bro?
I'm here.
Good morning, man. How's it going?
Things are looking fine. You know, it's a nice and cozy morning. Got some good CS ahead of us. Can't wait.
It's a beautiful Sunday morning, actually, man. Nice and bright and sunny, especially when it's been starting to get kind of chilly over here in Scandinavia. So I'm glad, man. I'm glad. It's like the last hurrah of summer, right?
the final lap of summer here in the Nordic countries.
Yeah, I can already hear winter's cackle in my ear, you know, the whispering. It's about to get cold, Semler. You better enjoy it while it lasts, buddy, because it's going to be the long night soon.
It's going to be six months of darkness.
Yeah. No. We can't think about it, Ben. It's too brutal.
We'll live. We'll live.
We'll survive, man. We're going to hunker down and just play a lot of CS. That's why, you know, people wonder, why are the Swedes? Why are the Nords? Why is everybody so good at CS? It's because winter. It's because we get like 5 hours of sunlight, and all you can do is just sit and play games all day.
Yeah. It's an okay trade-off, though.
I'm all right with it. That's all right. All right, let's go ahead and talk a little bit about what's going to happen today on the stream. So yesterday we went through the first three best of threes of Starseries. The Starseries 10 LAN is happening right now in Kiev, Ukraine. And we have the four teams. Today, we're going to be kicking off with HellRaisers versus myXMG. HellRaisers fell to Na'Vi yesterday in their first best of three of the day. And myXMG had the unfortunate luck to pair up with Fnatic early on in the day yesterday in our first best of three of the day, and will now be facing HellRaisers in the lower bracket. So this is going to be the best of three to decide which is the first team out of the tournament today.
No, nobody wants to be the first man out. Do we know the map pool yet for the entire best of three?
That's a good question. I don't think we have it yet. Hopefully we'll be able to get it. I mean, we loaded into Dust 2, so I'm assuming Dust 2 is going to be the first map.
Yeah,
and we already have the admin, you know, calling for the knife. So I think that the players are all going to be loaded up fairly soon here. But we're on Dust 2. Inferno is going to be the second map, and Mirage will be the map to settle it all if it comes down to it.
Ah. Well, with knowing the maps, I think my prediction for who's going to win or who's the favorite to win has probably not changed that much. But I do like myXMG's chances of picking up a map here. I wouldn't say that this is out of their reach at any point, really. HellRaisers, yeah. they are the clear favorites going into this, but we've seen them play under par, I guess, in earlier situations. But we've also seen myXMG upset big teams on, well, first off, Dust 2. They beat Na'Vi here.
Yeah, that's something to keep in mind, right? I think they're going to be pretty pleased with this first map to start things off. The Vito, I mean, I imagine, you know, maybe myXMG are the ones taking out Nuke, HellRaisers take out Train, and then, you know, from there on out. It's a five-map pool, guys. It's a five-map pool, so that's how things are going to break down. And with the three remaining maps, I think that XMG actually have a pretty fair shot at it. HellRaisers looked a little bit shaky yesterday on Inferno, not their usual invincible selves. I mean, they did give Na'Vi a bit of a run for it, but in the end, Na'Vi closed out the match. And myXMG, I feel like if they take this first map, going into the second map, HellRaisers are going to be hard-pressed. But already Dust 2, I mean, do you think it makes a big difference who gets to start on which side, Ben?
On Dust 2, I don't think it makes that much of a difference, really. I think it's more down to how good of a start can you get off to, and at that point, it doesn't really matter what side you're on. If you can get off to a 5-0 start on the T side, that's fine and dandy. Same thing goes for the CT side, but it's never hopeless for the team on the other side. You could always make that back and string even 10 rounds in a row back. So not too worried for any team that's going to get off to a slow start. and not really worried about the team who's eventually going to lose their knife round.
Yeah, that's the thing. We're going to get into the knife round now, so we'll get to figure out who's going to be starting on the defense and who's going to be starting on the offense. But I think you're right. I think it doesn't really come down too much to which side you get to start on. Dust 2 seems to be a map where teams seem to be really comfortable, actually, with both sides. Or, you know, if they get a CT start, you know, that is, you know, air quotes, the least favored side, right? So they get an opportunity to get some rounds on the board, get some confidence in before switching to their T side. And if you get the T side, well, you know, supposedly you have the easier time of it. So we'll see who's going to come out on top here in the knife round and get to decide, you know, where they want to start in this. But, you know, this is going to be on LAN in Kiev at the Star Series Center. And that's already pretty cool. HellRaisers, I guess, have a little bit of the home team advantage right here going into this match.
Well, yeah, being the CIS team, definitely they're going to have the crowd support. Not really sure, what's the local time in Ukraine right now?
I think it's plus one for us.
Plus one, okay. So I would assume even gamers have gotten up for this game at this point, so there might be...
Well, it feels
be,
like Star Series is an easier tournament to actually take part in, right? Because it's, you know, it's four teams only that are attending at the LAN, and you do have a pretty reasonable amount of time for setting up and, you know, starting, finishing. Like, it doesn't go too late, but it also doesn't start too early. So it feels like, you know, for as far as a tournament, a LAN tournament is concerned, that a lot of the teams actually have pretty good conditions to play in.
Oh, for the teams, absolutely. I'm thinking about the casual viewer who wants to watch his favorite team, if they have the willpower to wake up early in the morning, or somewhat early, I guess. But yeah, I think HellRaisers are, if anyone is going to get a boost from the crowd, it's going to be HellRaisers, at least in this matchup. I think it might have been different if you had HellRaisers versus Na'Vi going up against each other. I'm not really sure who's the bigger fan favorite among the two. But in this case, I think it's clear to say that HellRaisers are going to get more support in Ukraine than myXMG.
Yeah, that's definitely something. I mean, we could potentially see that later on today, because if you missed the first day of this tournament, we had the four teams play it out. Fnatic knocked myXMG into the lower bracket. Na'Vi put HellRaisers here into this match. But then Na'Vi and Fnatic went off to face against each other in the winner bracket final, and Fnatic took that best of three win. So they are waiting in the grand final right now. Na'Vi are waiting in the consolidation final that will be coming up next at 14:30 CET before going into the grand final to settle who's going to go up against Fnatic. So if it's going to be HellRaisers, if it's going to be Na'Vi, I guess we can say, you know, if it comes down to it, Na'Vi have done it once and they did it 2-0. If it comes down to a rematch, HellRaisers, it's going to be a really tough day for either one of these teams, basically, to make the comeback here.
One thing that I think bodes well for HellRaisers is the fact that I don't think we saw their best effort last night against Na'Vi, at least not on the first map. Inferno was a really close game. I think it ended 16-14. And the first map was definitely not the best showing from HellRaisers' side. So they're going to be eager to show that they can do better if they manage to dispose of myXMG first. So if they get the rematch versus Na'Vi, I think we're going to see one hell of a match.
I mean, that's the thing. That's what we're looking to see here. If myXMG can basically weather the storm, because I think HellRaisers have a lot to prove, especially after their Gamescom performance as well. I mean, this is the latest LAN after Gamescom, and HellRaisers, they didn't make it out of their group there, and actually took a 16-1 to the face in their first map of the tournament. So these guys have definitely got a lot to prove, especially since we know for a fact that they've been boot camping for a long time now, practicing together on LAN together for a long time. And so, you know, they need to have something to show for all that effort, I think, for themselves mainly as well.
Yeah, actually, right after Gamescom, after HellRaisers were knocked out, really, from the group stages, I saw a kind of funny tweet from the HellRaisers Twitter account, and they were kind of, I'm not really sure if they were poking fun at themselves or not, but they seemed to be in good spirits, because they were talking about, well, Gamescom didn't go quite as planned, but guys, we're going to do better at SLTV. We can promise at least a top four placement at that event. So, who knows? But yeah, they definitely want to get a better showing than what they did in Germany. And I'm not gonna close it out either. I think they can beat Na'Vi. I think they can beat myXMG. And even though Fnatic looked extremely good last night, I think a HellRaisers that shows up and plays their best, they can definitely compete with Fnatic as well, if that eventually becomes the case.
Well, it's whether the A team shows up with all the pomp and funfare, and you know whether the B team, I guess, shows up, which is always it always seems to be the case with HellRaisers. You know, who are they going to be able to peak together? Are they going to be able to show up with that A game, or are they going to be struggling as we've seen them do in the past, where they never really seem to show up in the match? So, I mean, that's what we're going to be watching. But already we get into the pistol round now. First round of this match, of this best of three here on Dust 2 starting, and already Adrian Plink down at mid, trying to catch somebody moving down Suicide with a good shot, and he's just going to take one to the face to start, so not going to be too pleased with that start here so far, HellRaisers.
And even though Adrian goes down to quite low HP, you can see Doja taking up a really aggressive position here. This is something we saw HellRaisers do last night as well, and yeah, Doja's just going full out aggressive.
Well, they know it's going to be the mid play here. Angel already manages to click one down, headshot to PNX on the B slope, and now they're trying to get into this site to wrap around on him, but Adrian saves him. Adrian's still alive, buying a lot of time, and Markeloff and Angel double-team the guy on slope. That couldn't have gone smoother. That just looked like it was an exercise there for HellRaisers. Adrian watching Angel's back as he was watching B slope, and they just shut down on myXMG's push completely.
Angel, I think he pretty much just shot three bullets and got three headshots. He only got two kills out of those, but he did a ton of damage. You can see he got two assists as well. And I think myXMG's execution there from upper was just a tiny tad too late, because Angel got the time to stand on plateau and help out from with the myXMG players coming in from middle, and that did a lot of work for HellRaisers.
Yeah, a bit of a wonky start here so far. Adrian is taking point, but he's got Doja to back him, and Doja is just holding down Mouse 1, getting those kills. Adrian's going to get overwhelmed, but Doja is still alive at cars on long, and he gets the last two kills. So, quad kill for Doja, one for Adrian, no ace, but still very fine work there by HellRaisers, just dealing with the anti-eco.
And I think it's good for Doja to actually get off to a good start. He had a bit of a rough start yesterday, and eventually he'll get back into his face because he's just that good of a player. So he's always going to be there and have an impact for your team. But if he gets off to a good start, I feel like he's going to go into monster mode and basically just destroy teams.
That's what we're always watching for Doja, right? He seems to be one of the more consistent players, but Angel is now pushed all the way up to top mid. He catches Hunden completely off guard, and he's even got the nade that he's going to sail down into lower dark. It's just a hair too early, but still the damage is done, and they know exactly where the remaining members of myXMG are right now. Doja's even pushed out from A-Long House to top mid just to make sure that there is nothing that can go myXMG's way here. Adrian holding the angle is just going to spray them down, and right now myXMG are just boxed in. The only way, only place they can go is T-Spawn, and they're trying to run back now to set up a bit of a crossfire.
Crossfire consisting of Glocks and a PT-50. It's probably not going to go as well as myXMG are hoping for right here. And I like the fact that HellRaisers are showing restraint here. They're not just running at the Danish teams.
We'll have to see. Doja spots the first guy, readjusts, and picks off the second guy. So very nicely done there by Doja. Another three kills for him. And you're right, man. I think Doja is one of the guys we have to keep a close eye on here throughout this entire series and throughout the rest of this tournament. If HellRaisers are to do well, Doja needs to be the man who's doing a lot of the damage for them, and already he's sitting on 7-0-0. Even if a lot of those kills are coming from just, you know, pistol beatdowns, he's still going to be building confidence and getting ready for this first buy round that's coming up from myXMG.
Absolutely, it's going to be a big part for. We talked about it last night actually. When Chris got that ace, it's an eco ace, but it still does a lot for your confidence, right? It's something that you can build on, you feel good about yourself, and that's pretty big. Playing with confidence is huge in CS.
That's what it's all about. You know, if you're not landing the shots, you can have all the strats in the world, but if you're not landing the shots, you're going to have a hard time. So, getting those kills in early, just making sure that you're nice and warmed up and you're getting your crosshair where it needs to be. That's what it's about right now. But myXMG have taken quite a bit of time spreading out across the map. They've worked two guys up to near top of Cat now. Tensky's going to be managing to get eyes on sight soon. He eats a bit of nade damage, though, so that's going to drop him down to 60. But it seems like myXMG now, they've dropped the bomb on Cat, but eventually they want to work their way back towards B, because they have the man in upper dark, and they start running through mid-doors towards B slope now, and Kucha's going to be the first man to spot this here for HellRaisers. And this is going to be the slaughter. Adrian alive on plateau, still here. Angel and Adrian both getting taken out eventually, but they've done some good damage, brought it back into a 3-on-3 here. And HellRaisers now just need to pace themselves, take their time with it. We do have Adrian getting up close to this, to the mid doors, or rather to the B slope doors, but they have to just wait for everybody to get here from HellRaisers, I think. They can't go rushing in.
Yeah, and they've actually got a Molotov as well, so they can zone out. You can see they've tried to zone out Kevin here.
And that forces him out into the open. Doja, however, is not going to be able to take out Hunden, who is waiting on the site proper. And it's only Markolov left with an AWP, not the best weapon to be using for a retake, and they're going to hunt him down. Hunden playing aggressive, looking down to B slope, and not letting Markolov get away. Once Markolov realized, okay, I've lost my mates, this isn't looking too good, tries to get away to save that gun, and it's just not going to happen.
There was some myXMG running a bit of a different iteration of a B-split. Basically, instead of going out through mid-doors and smoking off spawn from there, they went up Hunden and Tensky, I think, onto catwalk, smoke spawn off from there. Pretty cool, variation of the B-split, and it worked out pretty well for them as well. I think Adrian still did a really good job. He got the two kills that, I guess, the B-site needed to get to give the three remaining HellRaisers players a shot at retaking, but in the end, myXMG played it well, and they managed to deal with it, even when Kevin had to, move up his positions and in there at the back of the site as Markolov takes out Hunden. So, good start now in this round for HellRaisers.
Yeah, HellRaisers busting out the double op play as well. This could allow for Angel on the B site to have a little bit more movement. Kuchar could be here to hold it solo, but it seems like they want to position Kuchar to look towards B slope. I mean, that's kind of been the go-to play here for myXMG, going out through a mid push. So I'm glad that HellRaisers are holding solid on the B slope, or in the B site rather, with support from Adrian and CT, making sure that they don't overcommit. But it looks like myXMG this round want to change things up somewhat. They're going to go out for an A play, and Doja instantly gets picked off at pit. It's going to come down to whether Adrian can hold off the man pushing on Cat, and that's going to be Tensky, and Adrian instantly takes him out. So now, all of a sudden, HellRaisers, all they have to worry about is controlling long, and there's still a man alive, Markolov, on that A site, the first line of defense, to hold. Oh, great play, Angel. Though, by Angel. Turns it into a 2-on-1. And now it's just down to Kev, 1v2. He's alive on long, he doesn't have the bomb. And Kuchar will find the kill at the end. So, HellRaisers, they recover in the end.
They do. I'm still a tiny bit worried about how their A setup is going to play out in the long run. Because, as we could see, Doja's pretty much isolated to himself at long. And they did the same thing versus Na'Vi, only with different variations of aggression from Doja. I would preferably see him have some backup, either from Adrian or Markolov.
I don't understand Angel pushing out alone like this. I mean, granted, it is going to be an anti-eco round for HellRaisers. He pushes out to top mid and gets one kill, but he's completely alone. No support from short, no support from mid doors. Adrian is alive on Cat. They try and flash their way in here, myXMG, with some quick pressure, but there's two guys alive. MSL managing to put that M4 that he picked up to use. This is Angel's M4, and this is the problem with what Angel did. He just basically gave myXMG a weapon to use against his team, and that gets them another kill and could potentially net them a third here if HellRaisers aren't careful. Hunden has the bomb, and now he just needs to play the clock because he still has a minute left here.
He's got plenty of time to work with, and I agree. It was a bit of a weird decision from Angel. At first, I would have thought it was something similar to what we saw Fnatic do all of last night, really.
With
having one of the offers, because they do have two of them, basically covering them as they run up mid with two people. So you're using the buddy system in a lot of ways. But Angel decides to go on a bit of a solo mission, and myXMG are taking advantage of this. They've gotten three kills already, and Hunden is not dead yet.
No, Hunden is still here. He's putting that M4 to work. I mean, we saw, I think it was PNX managed to pick up one. He's actually going to get the flank on Markolov as well. Kuchar is now the last man alive here for HellRaisers. They've been picked off one at a time, and this is all Angel right here. Really, this is all Angel. He gave away that M4, and myXMG are doing a terrific job of punishing them for it. Hunden has only got 11 points of health, but he's got a plant. He's picked up two frags, and he could pick up a third. He finds Kuchar looking for the headshot, doing the best he can, and Kuchar can't seem to hit either. This is so close, the 1v1. Kuchar has the advantage, he's got the life lead as well, but Hunden will find the headshot, and that's what we're talking about, myXMG. Three kills for Hunden, and an eco round win.
That's Hunden winning a 1v3 because of that weapon that got dropped in mid earlier from Angel. That's a blow to HellRaisers face, and that's a huge confidence boost for myXMG, because they basically got a free round there. That's a round that they shouldn't have been able to pick up, but they take advantage of that tiny mistake that HellRaisers make.
That was really well done there by Hunden, and really playing it patiently as well. You know, he had a minute left, so that is quite a bit of time for him to work around the map. After the first pick on Doja, he works all the way back around along to find Markolov looking towards CT spawn. Just HellRaisers not being shifty enough, I suppose. You know, the Hound was on the hunt and he was hungry. He picks up that round, and that's a great way to bounce back into this. You're right, for myXMG, a definite blow dealt to HellRaisers. And now, HellRaisers, their money is in shambles. They have to go for a pistol round. So myXMG are in a terrific position to take control of this early half here.
Yeah, HellRaisers' money situation is actually so out of out of place right now that Kucher's not going to be able to buy up in the upcoming round either.
Yeah, it may have to be a double eco, or at least like a force with a FAMAS or something like that. Kucher's trying to get the point blank on Hunden. He will do it with that USP unsilenced. Doja actually managed to pick up a kill as well with the P250 from mid doors, but he's about to get caught here by PNX. PNX makes it into T spawn, and I don't think Doja spotted that fast enough, so he's going to walk right into PNX, and that's going to be an easy kill. But there are three members alive here from myXMG, and they are holding on this B side proper. Not a whole lot that HellRaisers can do to get in here apart from just full all out YOLO, pretty much.
And I think the smartest thing HellRaisers could do at this point is basically not attend for any sort of retake or defuse. Basically, just sit outside the bomb sites and hope to nab one of the guys as they run out.
Yeah, PNX getting that frag early, though, on Adrian is going to allow for... Well, MSL finds Markolov in the end, but it allows for myXMG to get out of that site. They know where they can go to avoid the CZ, basically. So, Markolov, he has to force it, and it looks like HellRaisers have to force it this round as well. Kucher, you're right, not a whole lot of money. He has to just go for FAMAS armor, not even the money for a nade right now. He could buy a decoy for $50, but, you know, decoys, meh.
Probably not the best investment, I'd say, at least not in its current state.
Maybe if it was buffed, you know, to I wonder how you could tweak the decoy to make it more fun to use, or make it more valuable. Regardless, right now it's going to be Angel with a nice little flash there. Adrian trying to support through CT smoke, but he's not going to get lucky with that last shot there. Down to 14 HP, PNX. But myXMG make a quick one-for-one trade. In the meantime, however, they have taken over the B site, and they will get the plant here. Kevin, all the way up there with that AWP now as well. This is so much time now for myXMG to just hold the fort. HellRaisers all over on the other side of the map at this point. And PNX, is he going to spot Kucher? Yes, he will. Kucher has no idea that PNX is holding such an advanced position in T-spawn. So a free kill there, and now HellRaisers down a man. They aren't even going to consider retaking this site.
And that's definitely the smart choice from HellRaisers. They went for a bit of a gamble there, stacking four people towards the E-bomb site. Didn't quite pay out. myXMG, not really sure if they had any sort of tell as to if there were, how many they were. Or well, Kevin, obviously, with the op, peek down middle, but anything in addition to that to give them the information, you know, they needed. But they really,
you're
just
right, they messed up the
it.
Smoke. They messed up the smoke at the beginning. HellRaisers messed up their cross smoke.
Yeah.
So they could have counted only one guy going across.
Yeah. But that's pretty cool to see from myXMG that they're so confident in their retake that as soon as they know that, well, they probably only have one guy, and even so, that one guy who's potentially going to help the guy on B is going to be in seed spawn. We can basically isolate him out. So they're just going to go for it each and every time. That's pretty good to see from the Danish side.
Oh, it's a shame to see them commit with the bomb to A long like this. I think they were expecting Doja to be there alone again and to have a free pick, because they've taken the bomb out there, the Danes, and now it's been dropped at the feet of two HellRaisers members. Markolov on the A site, holding from A slope, will find Hunden peeking out on Cat, and that's going to be another kill. MSL is now peeked out mid doors, and he's going to find Kucher trying to rotate in from B. But Angel's on the flank, and if MSL tries to go back through mid, it's not going to go well for him. Angel should have a free kill here, and he does. Or eventually.
took him a bit of time, but in the end, the result is the same. So it's all on Kevin to clutch a 1v4. I don't really see this happening for him. And the worst part is there's so much time left in the round, so saving the off for him is not really a viable option at this point either.
Especially since he threw out the smokes, he threw out some nades there to try and force a mistake and error out of HellRaisers, but now this gives HellRaisers all the information they need as to where he is on position, and Angel has already worked out to T-spawn to make sure that he can't actually get out of this box now that he's walked into. So Kevin, there is no saving. He's basically going to have to run out here and die at some point and hope to take somebody with him.
That is, at this point, the best case scenario, or actually, ooh. That could have actually been as opening as Angel showed himself there. Adrian, making sure that he's got his teammates back and is able to close in on him before anything scary happens. A good round from HellRaisers, though. A nice change, actually, in their setup. I do prefer them having two people towards long, so Doja has someone to fall back on in Adrian in that situation, because it seems like Markov should be perfectly capable of just holding off that catwalk area all by himself, at least for the initial push that myXMG can put out.
Angel's pushed into lower dark, though, but myXMG know this. Kevin's been watching from T-Spawn. They know exactly that somebody could potentially be here, and yeah, there you go. Easy kill for Tenski. He's going to pick up one. Markov is going to lob the nade down into lower dark, and that's going to finish off Tenski, though, so it's a quick one-for-one. Down into a 4-on-4 situation here. HellRaisers is trying to peek forward and get some early aggression out. Not really going to work. And myXMG, in the meantime, have taken advantage to push up long. They're trying to get some pressure on this A side fast, but a great flash sets it up. And Doja, with the double spray, double headshot, down long all the way, drops the bomb. And PNX, like that, is the last man alive here for the Danes.
He's going to pick up Kucher, but that triple kill from Doja right there more or less settles the round in favor of HellRaisers. And Doja really wants to get that fourth kill in as well. And actually, this is a doable situation for PNX if HellRaisers don't play this perfectly.
Yeah, PNX getting flashed. But Markov is holding alive on the A. Oh, he spots PNX jumping, can't pull the trigger in time though, misses the shot, PNX is gonna rush him down. This turns it into a 1v1 now. Adrian alive in pit, and he's been spotted as well. PNX knows where he is. Yes. Oh man, if Doja's peeking has cost HellRaisers, this would be huge. I mean, this is all about now just Adrian holding. PNX takes the shot, he's gonna drop him down to 16 HP. He's still got time to get to the site as well. He's picked up the bomb, and PNX, it could be another 1v3 for myXMG. He's got the time.
He's actually in a really favorable position now as well. Adrian has, well, quite a way to go before he actually makes it up to catwalk, and he's down to 18 HP. Is he just gonna give it up? No,
sure, he has to go for this. Yeah. That would be very weird if he decided to back off. He's still got time. He's got a kit. He's picked that up. And PNX now has to turn back and watch. He's spotted Adrian now. He knows where he's coming from. Adrian knows that PNX is alive on the site. He's going to be looking for this headshot as quickly as possible. Here, does Adrian do it? Adrian with the spray drops him down to 3. And PNX somehow can't land the shot. Now the question is, does he have the time? And Adrian does not. PNX bought enough time. Adrian can't get the defuse despite getting the kill. And that's another 1v3 situation won by myXMG.
That's crazy. You saw how well PNX did to basically just get people out. He got into 1v1 duels with a lot of the HellRaisers members, and he seemingly easily took them out, right? And when he gets down to that 1v1 situation, he couldn't land a single bullet on Adrian with 16 HP. So I think he felt the pressure right there, but bought enough time for himself, and the Danish team pick up another round. And again, that's a round that they probably shouldn't have been able to grab. So two rounds now that HellRaisers have, kind of given to them. So good for the Danish team to actually take advantage of it. They're making the most out of every single opportunity they're given now.
Yeah, that's the big thing right here, is that they're showing that if HellRaisers do make a mistake, myXMG are perfectly capable of getting a big punish and really punishing HellRaisers. I mean, there's another flash going to go out. Doja with the double spray down from CT spawn. He's just holding on the other side of that smoke and does massive damage. Sets it up for Kucha to peek out from window. But Kucha will get taken out. Only problem is Doja pushing through the smoke is going to turn this into a 1v2. PNX trying to take the fight with Markov, but he's not going to get it. Markov will come out ahead. And HellRaisers, they stabilize once again. This is so back and forth now, Ben. 6-5 the score, and HellRaisers, they're going to force myXMG to eco.
Yeah, and that's what you get with back and forth games. The economy is going to be all over the place, and in this case, HellRaisers were the first team to break their opponent. So they should be able to pick up another round here, kind of a freebie round, seeing how myXMG are more or less doing a clean eco, barring two pistols on their team. So this is a chance to kind of stabilize and get their money back where it needs to be.
Curious to see if Angel will get two kills, but they really are focused on this B split right now, myXMG. Smokes, I mean, they lost Hunden, who had the smoke, and they don't actually have one to use now, so they can't push past here. Adrian is just going to peek right forward, no fear from him. Hunts down Kevin. Doja finds Tenski through the mid doors, through the smoke as well. MyXMG, they tried to barrel through and actually just overwhelm Angel, but I think Angel did enough there with the two kills and slowing them down enough to allow his teammates to get into a position to stop MyXMG from breaking.
Yeah, and as you pointed out, getting down Hunden, who was the one guy carrying the smoke for MyXMG, is obviously going to do good things for HellRaisers, because that stops a lot of the pushing power from the Danes.
Oh, and it's going to be a full-on YOLO train on the B site now. Can Adrian hold? He's got an M4A4. He's going to be happy about those extra bullets, and he's already mowing them down. Two are gone. Who could get a third? He will. Gets dropped down to 1 HP and will finally get taken out. MSL and Hunden stepping it up. But Hunden is now the last man alive, and unfortunately for him, the bomb has been dropped all the way where Adrian was standing. He gets caught out on B slope, and HellRaisers will secure their 8th round now. MyXMG just eating 2 rounds of eco, very painful for them, especially when they were so close to taking control of this round, or this half, rather.
Yeah, if that one round at 5-5 goes their way, then all of a sudden it's HellRaisers ecoing. And we might have seen 8-5 in the Danes' favor.
Yesterday we saw, it seems like we were seeing Kevin have quite a big impact for MyXMG, but today he hasn't really had the opportunity to shine with that AWP. He's only picked up 3 frags this half. So we have to see if we can have a big round from him here soon to get MyXMG through. It looks like MyXMG again are going to go for a B-split push here. There's a close support, however. Agent's on the other side of the smoke and CT spawn. Angel decides to push out down B-slope. He's going to catch them stacked up, but he can't get a kill, and that's not going to help things. Kev finds Kucher, and that opens up the B-site.
And Doge does pick up PNX right now, but this is a 4v2, and very unlikely for HellRaisers to actually go for this at all. You can see Markleff is already backing off and getting some distance on the T's right now, and yeah, Doge follows suit, and he's going to pull back to long and basically hope to save their weapons. And I don't think MyXMG are in a position where they can actively go and hunt for these weapons, because it's not like it's going to impact HellRaisers in any big way, even if they down Doge or Markleff.
Yeah, that's the thing. 15th round, they're going to have enough money on HellRaisers to pretty much buy whatever they want.
Exactly.
The question is about whether MyXMG are going to commit to it or not, because MyXMG have spent a lot of money in this round. All of their money, basically, in this round. So, losing 2 guys, okay, you know, they can drop. But they wouldn't want to lose 3 or 4. Then it gets a little tricky. Now everybody has full nades. Everybody has AKs. So, we're going to have a real round here on our hands to close this half. Potentially 8-7 on the line here.
Yeah, and you were talking about we need to see a big round from the guys on MyXMG who hadn't really been up to snuff so far in this game, and we saw 2 great entry frags from Tenski and 1 from Kevin, and that pretty much opened up everything on the B bomb site and in the middle. So I think they heard ya.
The power. I'm not even wearing the hat right now. I did eat bacon this morning though, so maybe that's what's happening here with MyXMG.
Transfusion of power.
Oh yeah. Oh, we got to give them what we can, man. HellRaisers, you know, they're on home turf right now. And that does make a difference.
Yeah, look at Doge. We talked about it. Him getting off to an early start, that's big for HellRaisers. And he's rocking 21-6 right now. So he's definitely the raid boss of HellRaisers at this point.
I've been given a hat now. It's good. Don't worry, guys. The hat is ready. Markleff will find Hunden trying to peek up behind the smoke on Cat. That's not going to help things. PNX is now trying to push out onto B site, but Kucher is alive, and Kucher with some fancy footwork stays alive behind those boxes, will pick up the kill, and this turns into a 2-on-4 very quickly. Tenski trying to push out, find a kill through mid doors. He's not going to get anything done. And now MyXMG, they've got the bomb on Kevin, but Kucher is still alive on this B site. I would like to see a little bit, you know, Markleff actually come a little bit closer to this B site to lend a hand. Because if Kucher goes down, they lose that site very quickly.
Kevin does down Kucher, but Kucher gets that one frag, which is absolutely huge for them. But Kevin can still do some work here if he's able to get up into windows and pick off one of the HellRaisers members early on.
It seems like he wants to play it passively here. Adrian probably going to be waiting for the flash to peek. He's going to get the first one, but that gives it away for Doja, and Doja... 20 bullets it takes him, but he gets the job done. He will get the frag, and HellRaisers will finish this first half on a 9-6 scoreline. CT side, that's actually pretty good work here from HellRaisers, all things considered.
It's a very nice first half from HellRaisers. Absolutely. But we saw them last night having a bit of trouble on their T side. Obviously, the same goes for MyXMG, which is why both teams are in the lower bracket right now. Because, well, their opponents play better. So it's going to be exciting to see if both teams really have sorted out their mistakes from last night and are able to work with that from this point on, because obviously myXMG, I think they need to get off to a good start if they want to stay in this, because if you let HellRaisers kind of momentum train keep on chugging right now for three more rounds, if they get the pistol and the two anti-ecos that follows, then myXMG are going to be in a really tough position.
Yeah, HellRaisers are in a position to run away with this game, pretty much. I'm curious to see what exactly HellRaisers are going to throw at myXMG as well. How myXMG, they've taken the information. I'm sure that they were able to watch HellRaisers yesterday and get a bit of a feel for what HellRaisers were doing, how they were playing it out. myXMG will be prepared here. Dust 2, I mean, it really could go any way. And Danish teams are pretty damn good on the CT side and as a general rule, so we have to see if they're going to be able to weather the storm here. 10 seconds left, and we will be getting into the pistol round of the second half to see who actually comes out on top here in this first map of a best of three. Inferno will be the second map, and Mirage will be the map to close it all if necessary. But now we begin the second half, and I'm already curious to see exactly what they're going to be investing in here. And it is already a lot of nades for myXMG.
And a Molotov on Tinsky.
Two Molotovs.
Bonka. This is surprising. I'm curious to see what they're going to do with this. Because, well, actually it might work out pretty well because Markolov and Angel both have opted to go for nades. So those small tops, if they actually run into them or get caught in them, those are going to hurt.
Well, they're already down. They use those Molotovs early to stop any rushes. So nothing really being done too much with them apart from giving information to HellRaisers saying, okay, well, two guys aren't going to have Kevlar. So now we have to wonder, you know, myXMG, are they going to be able to weather the storm? We have the flashes and the smokes being put to use here from HellRaisers. They still have one on Angel, but Hunden? Well, Hunden is over on A long, so I'm not really sure what's going on with him.
He's just basically waiting to hear some sort of noise from HellRaisers on Catwalk, and he's going to bank that flash off the wall and get a pop flash for Catwalk.
It seems like they want to give a... It looks like HellRaisers want to go for a B-split right now. They've got the bomb in upper dark. They've got three guys prepared to go through mid-doors, and they're going to overwhelm the man holding. MSL instantly dies, but Tensky peeks out, picks up one, still alive, goes toe-to-toe with Markov, takes him and gets a third shot, takes Doja out point-blank, and that was a huge kill there. Now Hunden will walk in and pick off Angel and myXMG in a 3v1. Kocher finally gets that bomb plant and will take the first kill on Hunden. Now myXMG have to slow down the pace, and PNX does just that. Waits at the doors for his teammate to get into position. And this is a smart play here from PNX. He needs to take his time and set it up, draw the attention here to himself as Kevin works his way out from upper dark. Really nicely done there by myXMG, not letting Kucher get anywhere near securing that round after that first kill.
And myXMG can definitely give a tip of the hat to Tensky that round. That was a crazy 3K. I was even impressed by the fact that he would have been able to pick up two frags in that situation,
so
because he was getting sandwiched in fast.
I mean, yeah, that's the thing. I was just like, okay, if he gets Markolov here, that's already a big win as far as he's concerned. And then just out of nowhere, he even adjusted. It's not like he was just spraying, right, with his USPS. He actually adjusts for that third kill. So that was just really nicely done there by Tensky. That's all reflex right there. That's all killer instinct kicking in.
And myXMG get off to that good start that they needed. So this bodes well for the continuation.
But look at HellRaisers, man. HellRaisers pulling a HellRaisers right now.
Yeah.
They get that plant. They're like, screw it. We're not going to let out the pressure. We're not going to give them any kind of breathing room here. We're going to go straight for the throat, and they're going to go for it. Three rifles picked up, and now Hunden is already managing to do quite a bit of damage, but there's two guys alive on this B site, and they've got the crossfire set up. MSL starts off strong. He gets two kills, but there's still a man alive at the back of the site. That's Tensky with his rifle. Finds Angel, instantly picked off by Markolov, but the damage has been done, and myXMG now have a man advantage going on to this bomb site.
Yeah, you're exactly right. The damage has been done, and HellRaisers are going to have a hard time of getting the bomb down here if myXMG are ready to pounce for it.
You already have the pincer movement being picked up here. PNX in upper dark now. He's got two mates holding on B slope, making sure that HellRaisers can't push out and catch anybody by surprise. And then PNX just calmly waits. And I really like this from PNX. Rather than try and push in, all they have to do is play the clock and wait to hear that bomb plant sound. So PNX, he's calmly waiting to see if anybody's going to try and push at him through upper dark right now. Markolov is going to be the one he's going to run into in a moment's time here, and Markolov is going to watch for PNX, and that's actually a great play by Markolov. Great read by him. Spots him out and brings it into a 2-on-2. Nades go in. Herndon walks in. Herndon not gonna get them. He goes for the 180, but he doesn't get it. Markloff and Doja set up the crossfire and play it down to a T. HellRaisers take a huge risk and bounce right back. Then this time the risk works. This time it plays out well for HellRaisers.
The risk does work out after all. And as we were talking about how good of a job myXMG were doing of not pushing into the two remaining HellRaisers members, we saw PNX getting a tiny bit too overeager and gets picked off by Markloff, and that was pretty much the bane of myXMG that round.
Yeah, Markloff really figuring it out. MSL, look, we have a bit of a stack right now. MSL's actually going to get a free kill on Doza. The stack at mid-doors, and it worked perfectly. PNX, however, pushes out on Cat, and he's going to get punished by Angel, who is holding in lower dark, so myXMG, they do end up back into a 4-on-4 after that early lead. But you're right, PNX, Markloff finding PNX in upper dark was the big play, was the big difference there. That was a huge kill. It lets him come back to support Doja on that B site and set up that crossfire. Herndon, however, is going to get two kills for free. Kev sets it up, picks off Angel, and somehow myXMG find a way to be aggressive and turn this into a 2v1. Kucher is now alone. Kevin has picked up an AK, and there's still Tensky alive with a CZ, so he might as well have an AK. Everything is good right now for the Danes if they can just play it patient.
I'm kind of hoping for myXMG to willfully give up a bomb site here in this situation and just go as a duo and go for the retake after that. But actually, Kevin might be able to find Kucher. Oh, yeah, he spotted Kucher going out into mid, so this is big for myXMG.
Tensky, he's getting into a position where he's going to be able to jump Kucher as he comes in. Get real close with that CZ, turns into a near guaranteed kill. Kucher, he has so many angles to check right now. He's looking all over the place. He spots out Tensky, and Tensky can't get the job done. He was close, but not close enough, and Kucher's going to get completely blinded. Does Kevin find him in time? No, he does not. Kucher with the spray point blank gets three kills and saves it for HellRaisers. But that was a terrific eco round win, that was an eco round win for XMG as far as they're concerned. They kill off four members of HellRaisers throughout the process, but they did have a big opportunity there to upset HellRaisers and take a round away that they should not have got.
Yeah, with the way that round turned out, you can bet that myXMG are going to be the team that actually feels disappointed about losing that round, which is odd seeing how they started out being on an eco. But that, I guess, man mode mission that Herndon went on, dropping down into middle, picking up two frags, that was just massive for myXMG.
He got in so quickly behind them as well. You can see HellRaisers
weren't
even
turning around.
He was just a part of
the rush. Yeah, he was a part of the rush. Like, he was one of the HellRaisers
right
there.
He was a sheep in wolf's clothing, or is it the other way
around?
Yeah.
That was definitely unexpected on HellRaisers' part, for sure. They got caught out, but Kucher doing a good job of bringing it back for them. And I think that was a necessity for HellRaisers as well, because imagine how broken you get from that, because you have that positive feeling of bringing it back after losing the pistol, so you're thinking, we got this, we're back on the right track. And if you get slapped in the face instantly after that, it's going to take a toll on you. It's going to do something to your mentality.
I don't doubt it. Feels like there's been a lot of that, right, between both of these teams, though. Angel somehow lives with 3 HP. Angel, you'd better run away. Nope, he's going to get caught in the end. Kevin, however, I don't think he's going to be able to live to tell the tale. He will get hunted down. Everybody from HellRaisers converging on him. And him being the last man alive for myXMG. But now myXMG, they've gone through a couple ecos, and now they get to bust out the big guns. Hunden's not messing around. He instantly drops a SCAR 20 for MSL, and Kevin does have enough for his AWP. So a double scope play coming out here from the Danes.
I wouldn't be too surprised if you saw MSL being positioned at the back of plateau towards B, and more or less being left alone there to hold off B by himself after a while. Or actually, they're going to put him up by the window, so he's going to play a similar position to what C's does. He's going to rotate around from watching mid and whatnot, and Tensky picks up Kucher through the smoke.
That was really nicely done there by Tensky. Finding the right angle.
Good start for myXMG, and obviously getting that entry frag is a big deal, especially on an open map like Dust 2. And yeah, it also allows them to basically not having to rotate unnecessarily, and that's going to be big for them. Seems like HellRaisers are trying to converge towards the B bomb site, and I'm not sure if Angel is going to be the lone guy out into mid or not, but yeah, it seems like they're going to go all four into upper dark, and if Tensky gets... if he sniffs this out early enough, this is going to be a slaughter for MSL with that auto sniper from window.
The question is, I mean, it's interesting that they aren't leading with Markolov. It's going to be Adrian and Markolov walking in, but there we go. Tenski gets the first frag. Angel instantly picks off how MSL2 exposed at window, and Angel walks in and gets both frags on this B site. Big kills for him, and that opens up the site for business. Now it's Doja who gets dropped down to half HP, but myXMG, they have an AWP and two rifles to go for a retake with, and they aren't wasting any time. Hunden getting caught in mid-doors takes him a second too long, and Doja gets the punish. This is not looking good here for the Danes. myXMG now caught in a corner, and they just get closed in on. Markolov finds Kevin, and Doja will get his second frag.
I like the thought from myXMG that they want to go for a fast retake before HellRaisers get into, well, the optimal afterplant positions, but unfortunately for them, they couldn't find the right members of HellRaisers quickly enough.
Did Hunden get flashed, do you think?
Semi-flashed.
Yeah, semi-flashed, because he seemed to hesitate for a second there in those doors, and that actually allowed Doja to turn around and get him.
Yeah, and if they down Doja there, I think they have a really good shot at actually retaking the bomb site, but didn't quite work out that round. And I think we saw a bit of an issue with the setup that myXMG ran on the B bomb site there. MSL was just a tad too slow to actually react to what was going on in tunnels, and got severely punished for it. Because if he's able to watch towards tunnels, I think that's just going to be a mow down for him.
No, I agree wholeheartedly. I mean, especially if Angel just walks out. I mean, that's the thing. MSL for like a third of a second, he's exposed on window before he can drop down to that site, and that's all the time that Angel needs to find him and kill him. So, yeah, not a huge fan of that setup. We'll see if myXMG decide to adjust it. They're gonna have to come up with something here because HellRaisers are now on 14 rounds. myXMG once again have plenty of money to go for a really healthy buy here. They've got 6k across the board, so now we get to see what kind of toys they're going to bring to the fore, and it's just going to be four rifles and the AWP on Kev, so about as standard as could be. HellRaisers, however, plenty of money on their side. They are under no pressure right now. They've got all the advantage and quite a cushion to play with as well, so they should just be kind of going through the motions at this point, setting it up.
I do like the fact that myXMG put Kevin in mid, though. If he's able to get an early pick for his team, again, that should do a lot for them, but we've seen HellRaisers being able to work it back, even from a deficit on their T half, so...
But, Markolov. Yeah.
Oh.
Markolov, he knew where to look. He got up on Cat, held an angle, and just barely spotted Kevin out above the smoke there.
And that's an issue for him, myXMG, but they have a pretty nice setup towards Catwalk here, so if the flash from Hunden comes in at the right time, MSL can pick off Doja without any problem at all. Or as I say that, Doja casually walks back into Catwalk and avoids the danger. But Angel, though, is going to get picked off.
And the timing, I was about to say, that's unfortunate for MSL. He's going to miss out on the timing window that would have been perfect for him to get a punish on Doja, at least. But he does manage to find Angel, who was setting up. So Doja communicating that, hey guys, I didn't see anybody on Cat, it's clear. And then surprise, surprise, MSL is there. Now we're into a 4-on-4, and myXMG, they are kind of focusing on A, actually. They've taken Tenski off of holding B. They're going to put him back there. But they do have three guys towards A right now. This could be a pretty decent hold coming in here for the Danes if HellRaisers don't hit the shots.
This is still going to be a really tough retake, though, for myXMG, because they have no nades to work with, so they're going to have a hard time getting close, really. Hunden uses the last flash on their team, and this is go time.
It's go time. They have to land the shots, and Kutcher's still alive on the side proper, looking towards A slope. He's going to gun down two, but MSL runs in, gets two of his own, brings it back to a 2-on-2. PNX is calmly clicking away, finds Adrian, and now it's Doja alive and Gandalf. Last man alive spots out MSL, who was just flat defusing. They had no idea where Doja was, and Doja now in a perfect position to lock it out, but he can't get the frag somehow. PNX lives with one HP.
That's heartbreaking if you're
that's
Doja.
That's heartbreaking.
It really is, because PNX was sent down to 7 HP, I think, almost instantly. Almost instantly, and then he gets that one one hit in that does 6 damage. That's not what you want to see if you're HellRaisers. But
that
luckily,
box, man. Yeah. Doja's going to be like, why?
World Bank changes, why?
Yeah, 9 times out of 10, I would have said, but that seems to be the case. I don't know PNX again earlier on in his... it was PNX, not Hunden, but PNX in that 1v3, same sort of thing, right? He can't hit the bullet, and Doja at the end, you know, he hits the one bullet, but it's not good enough. It doesn't do the job. HellRaisers are currently pushing out, and again, it's going to be Kocher and Angel tag team to clear up that B site, but this is not going to be the focus here. MyXMG, they don't know it, but they're actually at the right place. Adrian is going to spot them running around the corner, and it's a slaughter. He gets two kills for free. PNX finally takes him out, but that's not fast enough, and he's going to walk right into the remaining members for HellRaisers. Doja will make up for the last round and find that headshot eventually. But you could tell that MyXMG, they thought it was going to be a B play. They had bought that fake.
Yeah, they were ready to save. They were so ready to save in that pit. Just hunker down, sit out and wait out the bomb timer. And unfortunately, Adrian is at the right place at the right time for HellRaisers. That's unfortunate. And that's obviously a big loss, because you can see the buy that MyXMG are able to force up now. It's basically pistols and grenades.
Yeah, exactly.
And Markloff has apparently removed his worlds. He has just no regard for doors at all.
Well, it's good to see Markloff. I mean, he's been saying that he's going to off more often for HellRaisers, so I mean, I guess it's good to see him pulling some flush of things. Adrian's going to find a nice shot there on Kevin, though. And this is going to be a 5-on-2 situation now. Hunden and Tensky. Tensky very low, but HellRaisers do get control of that A site. And this is a fantastic position for them to close out this first map in this best of three series. Angel will find the remaining two frags, and it will be a 16-8 finish here between HellRaisers and MyXMG. Inferno next to settle it. Now HellRaisers up 1-0.
Up 1-0 on the map that they lost to Na'Vi last night. So they have to be feeling good going into the second map, which is Inferno, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
Yeah,
it was 16-14 Inferno, I believe. Yeah,
16-14 Inferno, and obviously Na'Vi winning 2-0 versus HellRaisers. They kind of pummeled HellRaisers on Dust 2, so it seems like HellRaisers looked through the demos, learned their lessons, and cleaned up their mistakes, because this was definitely a different version of HellRaisers that we saw. I think it's sick to say.
After that round that Doja gave away, you know, the 1v3 clutches, right? HellRaisers tightened up their game and got their act together for the CT side. Doja actually dropping a 30 bomb exactly this first map, 30-0-10. So that's a fantastic scoreline for him. We'll have to see if he can keep it up. But guys, we're going to take a quick 5-minute break between maps here. So don't go anywhere. We have Inferno coming up next to settle this best of three potentially between HellRaisers and MyXMG here for Star Series 10.